Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Fraser Field for Catholic Central League Lodge action. This is the third try for these teams. They were supposed to play earlier in the season, and they got rained out, which is unusual for April because it hasn't rained that much, except every day. Then they were supposed to play here yesterday and got rained out again. And they almost got rained out today. It poured last night. But great job by the workers here, the DPW guys. They were here earlier this morning. They did a lot of work on the field. And looking out there at the baseball diamond, I mean, you would never know it rained. And boy, it rained last night. It rained as hard as I've seen it in a very long time. So hats off to those guys who worked here this morning. And they do it all year long, making sure this field is in tip-top shape. They do a great job here, and they don't get any notoriety at all. Most people, they just show up and say, oh, the game's being played. They don't realize that it took an awful lot of work by a lot of people all year long to keep this place up and running. And Manning Field as well, even though it's turf. There's turf here in the infield, but there's no turf in the outfield. Avon Cabral is getting the start against Arlington Catholic. And something's got to give here today because both teams are going for their fourth win. Arlington Catholic 3-3. St. Mary's 3-2. And the way the season's been going, it's going to pile up in the end of the year. Softball, it doesn't create that many problems because you got a softball pitcher who can pitch most of the games. That's normal, throwing a softball underhand. It's not normal to throw the baseball overhand, so you have to come up with a lot of pitches, and if you have to have games piled up, not many people have four or five pitches on their staff that they can throw out there the last week or so of the season. First pitch is a strike to Sam McEnany, the catcher, leading off for Arlington Catholic. Swing and a miss. Looked like Cabral took a little something off. McEnany was way out in front. Down and away for a ball. Hit right back to the mound. Nice job by Cabral. He's a shortstop when he's not pitching. That was catch it or read it at the mound. Hit right back at him. And he made the nice play. Sean Simmons, the second baseman, will hit. Cabral's been a pleasant surprise for Coach Derek Dana. Only a freshman. He stepped in to play shortstop, as I just mentioned, and doing some pitching. Lee Pacheco has been the shortstop for a couple of years, but he got hurt in football, hurt his arm. They're hoping he's going to make a bit of a comeback because he's a very good pitcher as well. So they thought it was going to hurt him not having Pacheco at short, but Cabral has filled in nicely, and he's given him a couple of nice starts on the mound as well. So a very pleasant surprise for Coach Derek Dana. Hit foul off the headgear of the catcher, John Moretti. I mentioned Derek Dana, the head guy. Timmy Fowler, Tommy Donahue, his able assistants have been with him for a long time. All three were very good athletes at St. Mary's. Thought about it and held up on a pitch that broke down on the turf. Timmy Fowler and Tommy Donahue were, Timmy Fowler and Derek Dana were battery mates when St. Mary's won back-to-back state championships under Jimmy Jettis. He misses for ball four, so Simmons draws a walk. It'll bring up Jason Smith, the shortstop.
Jason Smith.
if they were watching the last game on the Catholic, they probably would decide not to run on Joel Moretti. He threw out three base runners his last game. Missing down and away. We apologize for the netting blowing around in front of your screen. They still haven't fixed it. And those of you who are familiar with Fraser Field, it's starting to collapse. The covering is now falling apart, stuff falling down from up top, large chunks of cement. They have cordoned off all of the sheeting underneath the cover, so you can't sit there. And netting, with all the terrible weather and getting blown around, it just got blown into oblivion, and it's all over the place, blown around out in front. Tap to first base, foul. Went down about halfway down the first base line and kicked out, foul. And the count goes 1-2 to the Arlington Catholic shortstop. I think they're the Cougars, if I remember correctly. Cougars against the Spartans. Simmons is getting a very short lead at first base. They throw over anyway. It gets away, it goes by, and he's going to go to second base. He wasn't off the back far enough for Cabral to worry about him, but he threw over anyway, and the error allows the runner to go to second base. So the error on the pitcher puts a runner in scoring position for Arlington Catholic. Hit in the air to center field. Kyle Lillette drifting back. Makes the catch. They'll tag up. Now he fakes tagging up and goes back. He probably could have made it. That was well out in the right center field. So two-way now. Packy, Bradley, Lorenz is the hitter. Hangs up and in for a ball. Popped up. Lee Pacheco, the first baseman, had it and dropped it. Second error in the inning. Had it and just didn't close the glove on the ball. And he's coming in now. I think he wants to change his glove. He had it in his glove, and before he could close it, he dropped it. So first and third now. St. Mary's right now being very gracious host. A walk and a couple of errors that put runners at first and third with two outs for the third baseman, Mike Paulo. High for a ball. Oh. hit in the air to right field, starting back and now coming on. The wind played a little havoc with that. But Austin Foglietta able to make the play out in right field. Started to go back, started to come in, and had a drift toward the line. Anything up in the air is going to be an adventure today. So the walk and two errors don't hurt. St. Mary's gets a break. They get out of the inning unscathed. And St. Mary's has a chance to grab a lead in the bottom of the first. Colin Ray, the second baseman, will lead it off. Center fielder Kyle Ouellette will hit second. Catching and batting third, John Moretti. The shortstop, Jared Coppola, hits number four. Lee Pacheco, the first baseman, hits number five. Batting six is the DH, DJ DeCenzo. He's hitting for the third baseman, Bobby Alcock. The right fielder, Austin Foglietta, hits number seven. Batting eighth and pitching, Avon Cabral. And Connor Donahue, the left fielder, will bring up the tail end of the batting order, batting ninth. Catholic Central League action. We're winding down April, and we'll be glad to see April go. It's been a horrible month. It's another horrible day here at Frazier Field. The flag is almost blowing off the pole. It's chilly and cold again, damp. I don't think we've had two good days of baseball. And I'm not talking about perfect baseball. I'm just talking about two decent days. Even when the sun has been shining and blue skies, the breeze has been blowing around, keeping it chilly and forcing people to bundle up. We got a few brave fans here. Some from, a little smattering from Arlington with their team. A little more over behind the St. Mary's dugout. St. Mary's fans here. Decent following, especially for a day like this on a Saturday afternoon. To be back here tomorrow, Sunday, taking on Spelman. And it's unusual to look over at Manning Field and not see anything going. It's usually going 24/7, both these fields. It's lacrosse and track, and now they even have a flag football league that comes in and plays on the turf. They divide up the turf going cross field into two or three fields and play games, and then they wind up having playoffs when they wrap up their season. Colin Reddy, we mentioned, very good hockey player. And I know he's a little heavy playing this year without his two staunch fans, grandmother and grandfather, Ann Reddy and Tom Reddy. Tom passed away early, and Ann just passed away a short time ago. They followed Colin, along with the rest of his family, religiously. Two big losses, and the Reddy family is outstanding family in the community. His father and uncles, relatives of firemen, policemen, but they're great in the community. They do a great job. I know he misses them. They followed him. They were his best fans. Had an outstanding season. I think he was the leading scorer for the hockey team. To deep shot, long throw across the diamond. They get him. Nice play by Jason Smith, the shortstop. That's a long throw. It looked as though Colin Reddy made a slip a little bit coming out of the box. He didn't get a great jump. But a great throw by Smith. Good stretch by the first baseman, Pazia. So one up, one down for Kyle Ouellette, the center fielder. Missing inside for a ball. Missing wide for a ball. awful tough for these young men to play baseball or softball either. Standing around waiting for a ball to be hit in this cold weather. And when you finally get one, you're ice cold, hard to make the plays. Way inside, going to the backstop. Had to dance out of the way of that one and not get hit. Supposed to take one for the team. 3-1 the count. Kyle Lillette will be fussy here. It's got to be a very good pitch. The 3-1 delivery. Down and away for a ball. So in both instances, the second hitter for each team draws a walk. John Mulready, the catcher, is the hitter. Hit foul to the screen, what little screen is left there behind home plate. You could never hit a foul ball into the press box here. We were well protected, but now you can. You have to bring a glove here if you work in the press box. You become an extra fielder. Wide for a ball. One won the count, them already. High and tight for a ball. The runner takes off. In with a stolen base. So that puts himself in scoring position. Good pitch for a strike. Count goes full to him already. Jared Coppola, the shortstop on deck. Hit way up in the air. Shortstop chasing it again, finally makes the play. That's what we meant when the up in the air was gonna be an adventure. He looked like he was gonna make the play right at shortstop. And it kept blowing away. He wound up making the catch almost in front of the second baseman. Two-way for Jared Coppola. Nice play by Smith, the shortstop. That's not an easy play. Normally it is. Broke a little late, caught the inside corner for strike one. Hit solidly to short, right at the shortstop. He makes his third play in the inning, two assists and a putout. So Shamirius gets a runner in scoring position, but leaves him there. And at the end of one, we're right back where we started. We were dead even when we started. We're dead even at the end of one. St. Mary's nothing, Arlington Catholic nothing. Nick Pazia, the first baseman, will lead it off. 6, 7, and 8 for Arlington Catholic. They're not using a DH. St. Mary's is. In for a strike from Cabral. Nice, smooth, easy motion by Cabral. Catches the outside corner. Nice pitch. Swing and a miss. First strikeout for Cabral. Starts the second inning. Marquelo Polo, the right fielder, is the hitter. Hit foul to the backstop. Missing again for a ball. Starting to see a little bit of action over at Manning Field. Lacrosse players working out. Wide for a ball. So for the second inning in a row, Cabral walks the second hitter. Will Anfield, the left fielder, will be the hitter. Actually, looked like it lightened up a little bit. I look out in left field, is a little, just a little dot of a blue sky. Almost looked like somebody turned the lights on here. It got a little bit brighter. In for a strike. Hit foul back. One, two, the count to the Arlington Catholic left fielder. Throw over, diving back is Paulo. Good pitch, that caught the inside corner, just froze him at the plate. Looked like it was going to be inside, just broke and caught the inside corner. Nice pitch by Cabral. Two strikeouts in the inning. Anthony Pisa, the center fielder. Takes it for a strike. Reaches for that, slaps it foul over the St. Mary's dugout. Oh, 2 the count to the Cougar center fielder. Jammed him inside and just got a piece of it. So we'll do it again at 0-2. Hit the second base. Pacheco started to go after it and then hustled back to cover first as Colin Reddy takes care of the play. So an easy inning, even though he walked a batter. Two strikeouts, a tap to second. Caprell has got St. Mary's through the two innings. Picked up his first two strikeouts. And for St. Mary's, it'll be 5, 6, and 7. Lee Pacheco, DJ DeCenzo, Austin Foglietta. They face Packy Bradley Lorner on the mound for Arlington Catholic. Winding down April, we'll get into May, and we'll finally get to the, when we get to the end of May, we'll be in time for the annual Clancy tournament. I think it's like 26 years, maybe. It's really up there. It's been a long time, the Clancy tournament here at Fraser Field. Started out with the four Lynn schools, one in North Reading for five teams. One team would sit out. They would alternate. A team would sit out every year. And then finally Lynn Tech dropped out, and it was just English, Classical, St. Mary's, and North Reading. That was Frank Carey brought them here. It was coaches who played for NIPA looking for a couple of extra games at the end of the season, getting ready for the state tournament. Frank Carey, Dickie Magg, Jimmy Jettis, Bart Conlon at that time got together and said, let's have a tournament with the four Lynn schools. They put it together and they said, what better way than to name it after outstanding baseball coach and a great character, and I say that in a very meaningful way, in the city of Lynn. He was great in the community, helped a lot of people. And his sons, Chipper and Jimmy, were involved, and they gave away an awful lot of scholarships. Scholarship money. Lee Pacheco drills it into center field, and that's the first hit of the ball game. DJ DeCenzo, the DH, hitting for the third baseman, Alcock, is the hitter. DJ had a very good year in football. Enjoyed a Super Bowl game at Patriots at Gillette. The runner takes off. Nobody was covering second base. Shortstop went behind the bag to take the throw. Pacheco had second base made to order. Second stolen base, second time St. Mary's gets a runner in scoring position, this time with nobody out. It fouled out of play. That first pitch to Senzo faked like he was going to bunt, trying to protect the runner. That one hits him on the back. Hit him right on the number 33. Yeah, it was just a little bit inside. So first and second now with nobody out. Austin Foglietta. And we're going to get a runner at first base. Smith will be the runner at first. Let's see if they play small ball here with Foglietta. There's two of them, Chris and Will. Chris getting a start in right field in this one. Squares the bunt, takes the pitch wide for a ball. I mentioned there, father was involved in fire department in the city of Lynn, and their grandfather was a huge factor in the Babe Ruth complex. Push that bunt down. That's going to be a base hit. They got no chance to get him. A perfect bunt by Foglietta. But that Babe Ruth complex, the grandfather worked for the city. He helped put the wiring in for the scoreboard and everything they needed. He did a great job and did a lot for the community, the grandfather. Outstanding gentleman. They shortened up at first and third, but they played double play depth at short and second. Down and away. Catcher McInerney had to go to his right, save a run there. Avon Cabral can help himself here. High and tight for a ball. 2-0. Goes after the pitch and fouls it off to the right side. Count goes 2-1. Hits it foul again off to the right side. The 2-2 pitch, up and coming. Nice stop by McInerney, the catcher. Keeps the bases loaded. And the count goes 3-2. Oh, big pitch coming up for both teams. Pitching from the stretch with the bases loaded. High for ball 4. Cabral gets an easy RBI. Samirs gets on the board first. And they'll be looking for more with the bases loaded, nobody out. Connor Donahue. The left fielder will be the hitter with the top of the order on deck. Nice stop by McInerney again, pitching the turf. Have to say turf, the only dirt out there is on the mound. Everything else is turf in the infield, grass in the outfield. Although that might change. Fisher College, who does a great job here, they play all their games here. Rich Avery, the guy that's in charge of these two complexes, they're getting together to try and raise some money to put turf in the outfield. Wide for a ball. So Pacheco started with a base hit. DeCenzo got hit by a pitch. Smith went in to run for him. Foglia laid down a perfect bunt down the third baseline to load the bases. And then the pitcher Cabral helped himself draw on a walk. So that's where we are. 1-0 St. Mary's. 3 on, nobody out here in the bottom of the second. In for a strike. Swing and a miss. And he comes all the way back to even account at 2-2. Nice stop again by McInerney. He's getting a workout in this inning. And once again, the count goes 3-2, and another big pitch coming up. Slices it foul down that grassy knoll behind first base. A few more patches of blue sky. Popped up. Slicing down the right field line. Long run, can't get there. Good effort by the right field Apollo. Try to dive and make the play. Had to go a long way. He was off the line for a right-hand hitter. Long run by the first baseman and second baseman as well. So we'll do it again at 3-2. High for ball four. Another walk, another RBI. It doesn't get any easier as they take a trip out to the mound. Top of the order, Colin Reddy will be the hitter. As St. Mary's has been gifted with a couple of runs. Back-to-back walks with the bases loaded. And don't be shocked here if Colin Reddy tries a safety or a suicide squeeze. He can handle the bat well. This is a perfect opportunity for him to lay the ball down. They're going to stay with Bradley Lorna. Derek Danner, Colin Reddy, and Tommy Donahue had a little conversation. Pitching from the stretch again. Didn't show, but takes it for a strike. Hits it in the air, foul down the left side. So I thought it would be a perfect situation for Colin Reddy. He handles the bat very well. But Derek Danner going for the big inning, swinging away. The count is 0-2 to Reddy. High for a ball. I think the Catholic is back at double play depth all the way around. The only one in fairly close is the third baseman. He's about even with the bag. Way inside, almost. It did hit him. The umpire said it got a piece of his shirt. The beat goes on. Second hit batsman in the inning. High and away for a ball.
Bogey.
Well, Ed almost got hit with that pitch. He's been up once and walked. just caught the letters. That's borderline strike, but it's 2-1. At the letters on the inside corner. Low for a ball, 3-1. He's on the verge of walking in another run. They got two hits in the inning. One was a push bunt down the third baseline. They've got three runs and the bases loaded. They're on the verge of maybe getting another one here. Stepping off, Kyle Lett will be extremely fussy here. It's got to be a pitch that he can drive with the count 3-1. Yeah, that's ball four. So the RBIs have been very easy. Three walks and a hit, Bassman brought the four runs in. And they stay with the pitcher. I'm not sure how far they're going to go. John already popped to the shortstop. Just one trip. Great start by McInerney, the catcher. He didn't even know where the ball was. He just threw his body in front of that. At least momentarily saved a run. That's a great stop. So one ball, one strike. On the inside corner. And the count goes 1-2. Chop, foul. That'll keep the count 1-2. He'd love a base hit, but he'll take a fly ball. Trying to get a run in. Breaks down and away. And the count evens at 2. Low for a ball. He had already in the hole. Now he's got to come in with a pitch or bring in another run. Another big pitch for both teams. That's going to be in the gap in right center field. Two runs are going to score. They're sending the third guy home from first as it was bobbled in the outfield. Three runs are going to score. A big double by Mulready. And that's going to be a trip out to the mound, and that's going to be a change for the pitcher. Seven players have scored. The eighth player is at second base, and there's still nobody out here in the bottom of the second inning. Mike Paula was the new pitcher. The pitcher, Packy Bradley Loren, goes to center field. So I'm assuming that means the center fielder is going to third base. Jared Coppola grounded out, shot to first, this one trip. Fritz is the runner at second base for Mulready. High for a ball. Jammed him inside, took something off, and he swung right through it. Capole's the ninth hitter in the inning, and we have no outs. High for a ball. This hit way up in the air. That's going to go out of play. So it's the second baseman who moved over to play third base. Way up and in for a ball. So here we go again, 3-2. Pop, that's... The catch is made, it's gonna be a double play. The runner took off, nice catch in right field. And they'll turn the double play, the runner got off and running. Looked like Capola's gonna get a base hit. So there's two outs. Lee Pacheco got this inning going with a base hit and scored the first run. Up for the second time. In for a strike. So... Way inside, Pacheco guiding the plate, chopped it foul. Runner at second thought that was going to be a base hit. I thought it might be a base hit as well, but he didn't wait to see if it dropped. He took off. The right fielder, Marcelo Paulo, made a nice catch out in right field. He's left-handed, made it a little bit easier for him. But it was still a very nice play. Hit foul past third base. And easy double play at second. The runner was still standing at third when he threw the ball to second to complete the double play. Hit foul again out of play. Well, Pacheco's got a base hit and scored a run. In this inning, up for the second time. Hit in the air to center field. Drifting back. And now making the one-handed catch going away. That ball drifted all over the place. So they get the third out. They send 10 hitters to the plate. Seven of them score, most of them on walks and hit batsmen, but a big three RBI double by Moretti put the exclamation point on the inning, and St. Mary's has grabbed a 7-0 lead over Arlington Catholic at the end of two. Top of the order, Sam McEnany, the catcher, bounced to the pitcher, leading off the ballgame, his one trip. And now Avan Cabral can breathe a little easier. He's been given a 7-0 cushion. In for a strike. Hangs up and in for a ball. Hit in the right center field. That's going to be a base hit. That's the first hit for Arlington Catholic. And it leads off the third. Sean Simmons, who's now the third baseman, is the hitter. I think you can tell from your screen that the wind is still blowing with that screen in front of us, bouncing all over the place. Down the way for a ball. Simmons drew a walk in the first inning. Made it around to third when St. Mary's made a couple of errors. They try to pick him off for the first error as he slices it foul down the right side into that grassy knoll. And then there was another pop-up drop that allowed him to get to third. But then they got the fly to right field to end the inning, leaving the runners at first and third. I'm not sure why Cabral is worried about the runner on the base pad with a 7-0 lead. Popped up, ready. Couple of steps, the outfield grass again, tailing away from him with that wind, but he stayed with it and made the play. Jason Smith, the shortstop. Flied Olette in center field as one trip. He throws right and bats left. Hit the shot, sharply hit. They get one. Safe at first. They thought they had the double play. They get the main one in the middle. Packy Bradley Loren is now the center fielder. He was the pitcher. On the inside corner, Cabral took something off and floated it in. Hit the third, Alcock with the long throw across the diamond, rifle shot from Alcock. Shows you how that fastball works. When he's on the mound, he's the stud for St. Mary's pitching. So the hit doesn't hurt. We'll move into the bottom of the third with St. Mary's comfortably ahead. St. Mary's looking to stay over 500, 3-2. Arlington Catholic is trying to get to 500. They're 3-3. And Mike Paulo will start an inning for the first time. He came in and got Arlington Catholic out of what was a disastrous inning for them. They went a long time watching walks and hit batsmen. And finally, the three RBI double by Mulready. They finally brought Paulo in. He got helped out with a double play and then got the fly to center field. He faced two hitters and got three outs. And got Arlington Catholic out of further trouble, but a deep enough hole now, 7-0. E.J. DeCenzo got hit by a pitch. Smith went into run for him, and Smith came around to score. That was the inning. We got two bases loaded walks. I hit batsman with the bases loaded. Another walk with the bases loaded. So DeCenzo re-entered as the DH. And he'll lead off the bottom of the third. And boy, those blue skies are disappearing quickly. And the wind has really picked up and it's got very cold here. We had better weather for football. Hit foul to the backstop. I'm surprised by now the backstop hasn't just blown away. And the wind really picks up now. Hit up the middle, into center field for a base hit. He's on for the second time. They won't run for him now because if they do, they have to take him out. Or are they going to? They are going to run for him. Luciano will run for him. That should mean that his day is done. Austin Foglietta laid down a perfect bunt. He was looking to sacrifice to move the runners up in the second inning, and he pushed it down third perfectly. Didn't even bother to throw. They hit, didn't hit any play anywhere. Beat it easily for a base hit, and he scored a run as well. In for a strike. So Luciano was the runner at first. Almost threw that one away. Mike Paul threw it over to Pazio at first base. Pazio had to come off the bag to grab it. Solidly hit. That's going to be too easy. Shortstop was in perfect position. He caught it. He was a step away from second base. Fogley, you can't hit any better than Fogley had to hit it. And the shortstop couldn't have been any better placed. He had to take one step to the bag. Foglietta wasn't even out of the batter's box. Second double play for the Cougars. Slice foul down the first base side into that grassy knoll. Evan Cabral drew a walk for an RBI and scored a run. Down and in for a ball. It foul off to the right side. Way wide. McEnany again, the catcher going way out to get that one. Strike three called. So even with the base hit, Paulo only faces three hitters in the inning. St. Mary's is down in the third. We played three full. The second inning is the difference, where St. Mary's got seven. And at the end of three, it's St. Mary's seven, Arlington Catholic nothing. Third baseman now, pitcher Mike Paulo is the hitter. He flied out to right field, his one trip in the first inning. I'm not sure he thought he would be on the mound today. Certainly not sure he thought he'd be that quickly on the mound in the second inning. But he's done a nice job coming in relief. He's had St. Mary's hit into two double plays. Hit to center field. Looked like it was going to be in the gap in center field. The wind just carried it right over. Ouellette only had to go a couple of steps to his right. So one pitch, one out. Nick Pazia, the first baseman, struck out swinging. A stop by Moretti on a pitch in the turf. In for a strike. Hit the third, long throw across the diamond. It pulls Pacheco off the bag. I hate to give Bobby Alcock an error on that throw, but if it was on the bag, he's out. So it has to be an error. Longest throw on the diamond behind third base. He was deep, made the good strong throw. Just pulled Pacheco off the bag. They would have had him. I stopped him already. Marcelo Paulo drew a walk his first time. Hit foul back to the screen. Slices it foul off to the left side. Swing and a miss. He can't go. It's a strikeout. First base is occupied. Third strikeout for Cabral. Will Anfield, the left fielder, is the hitter. And I shudder when I look at Will Anfield. He's got that little shirt, short sleeve shirt on with his arms wide out in space, and it's freezing out. And he drills a base hit into center field. I don't know how he's staying warm. Second hit for Arlington Catholic. Anthony Pisa. He was the center fielder before they made a change. He bounced out second to first. Oh, Over but low for a ball. Coming in, I said to the Arlington Catholic coach, I said, I bet you wish you were playing this game in December when the weather was better. Easy play for DeFilippo making the play at second base. So Arlington Catholic gets two more on base. They leave two more with a couple of hits. We're halfway through the ball game as we move into the bottom of the fourth. It'll be 9-1-2 for the Spartans. All the damage being done in the second inning. Paula was come on to put out the fire. But it was a little late. St. Mary's put seven on the board. Connor Donahue, then the top of the order, calling ready Kyle Ouellette to face Mike Paulo. All three of these guys got an RBI in the second inning. Donahue with a bases loaded walk. Reddy with a bases loaded hit batsman. Ouellette with a bases loaded walk. And all three of them came around to score on Mulready's three RBI double. High for a ball. Swing and a miss. Evens the count at one. Little late swing. I don't know if he thought that ball was going to break over the plate. It broke. It did, but it broke down. And a late swing, he just swung right through it. Strike three called on the outside corner. Back-to-back calls, third strikes. One to end the third, one to start the fourth. Reddy has bounced a shot, got hit by the pitch for an RBI and scored a run. So officially he's 0 for 1, but he's got an RBI and a run scored. That was the run and the RBI were all in the second inning. Reddy will be looking all the way at this one. There you go. takes it for a strike. And again, he'll be fussy here. 3-1 the count. It's got to be a pitch he can handle. Lines it in the right field, coming on right at the knee. Nice job by Marcelo Paulo in right field. Ready, hit it right on the nose. It stayed up long enough for Paulo to help his brother. I'm assuming they're brothers. Two up, two down. Kyle Ouellette is perfect. He's walked twice. So officially he hasn't batted, but he's got an RBI and a run scored. Lined in the right center field. Paulo's not going to get that one. That's in the gap. Ouellette on his horse, heading for second, in with a stand-up double. On for the third time. He's finishing up a great career. Kyle Ouellette got to play with brother Corey as defenseman for the hockey team. Had played outstanding hockey for St. Mary's. And he's played very well for the baseball team as he's finishing up a career that he can be very proud of. In for a strike. Tom already popped to the shortstop and ripped a double with the bases loaded, knocking in three. And he gets hit on the number 13. That's the third hit batsman by Arlington Catholic, first by Paulo. Jared Coppola grounded a shot, lined it right to the right fielder who made the first of the two plays. He made another one here in this inning. We get a runner for him already at first base. That's the other Foglietta. Will Foglietta. Up and away for a ball. High for a ball. Down and away at 3-0. In for a strike. Again, still going to be fussy with the count 3-1. On the inside corner. So the count goes full. The automatic hit and run. The runners will be off with the pitch. Hit in the left field for a base hit. That's going to score a run. And with the runners going, they're able to move up. Big two-out hit by Coppola. First run off Paulo. Lee Pacheco singled, scored, and then fly to center field. That was both at bats in the second inning when St. Mary sent 10 to the plate. So first and third with two outs. All of this has come with two outs. Two outs, nobody on. Ouellette got a double. Moretti got hit by a pitch. What a stop by the third baseman. What a great play by Sean Simmons. He went behind the bag, backhanded it, and in one motion threw Pacheco out. Took a hit and an RBI and a runaway from Pacheco and St. Mary's. That's an ESPN highlight play. Well, St. Mary's gets another run. They get a couple of hits. The hit batsman extended the inning. We played four full. St. Mary's with a touchdown and a safety, leading Arlington Catholic 8-0 at the end of four. Colby Magliozzi will be the new second baseman. Terrence Moynihan will be the new third baseman. And behind the plate will be Will Foglietta, the new catcher. For Arlington Catholic in the fifth, it'll be the top of the order. Sam McInerney, the catcher, has bounced to the pitcher and singled. He has one of the two hits that Cabral has given up. He's done a nice job behind the plate. He's been bouncing all over the place. In for a strike. Cabral starting his fifth inning of work. Down and away for a ball. Oh, Derek Dana getting some players some playing time. Foul tip. That looked like it went off the umpire. 1-2 the count. Missing low for a ball. So we got the Foglietta family in the game. One in right, one behind the plate. Hit foul back and out of play. Hit out of play again. Count stays 2-2. I smile when the ball's hit out of play because they don't send one guy. They need a team to go chase the foul balls. St. Mary's has a duo chasing foul balls. Main man and a backup. Once again, 2-2. We're running out of baseballs here. Nice job by McInerney. By Moynihan. Just came in the ball game. Goes way to his left. Cuts it off and makes a good throw. That's a base hit if it goes by him. So Terrence Moynihan making the play. Pitch misses for a ball. Sean Simmons made that outstanding play behind third base, ending the bottom of the fourth. Hits it the deep shot. What a great throw. Nice play by DeFilippo. Two nice plays in the infield. That's a long, he was almost on the outfield grass throwing Simmons out. Two up, two down. Jason Smith, the shortstop, has flied to center and hit it right on the nose and wound up with a fielder's choice. DeFilippo made the play. Hits it in the right field for a base hit. I thought for a minute we might have a 1-2-3 inning. We haven't had one yet. Packy Bradley Loren, the center fielder. DeFilippo just moved. He was over at shortstop. He took one or two steps towards the second base bag, and it was just beyond his reach to hit into center field. If he stayed where he was, it would have been right at him. So two outs, 2-1 for Mike Paulo. Mike Paulo came in relief and did a very nice job. They finally got a run off him in the fourth. Helped out once again by a hit batsman. The runners take off. It's going to be a wild pitch. They were running on the pitch. Smith was bolting to his third. So it's second and third now, as Arlington tries to get on the board. Nice stop by Foglietta. Hit in the right field, a base hit. That's going to score two. So a little two-out lightning for Arlington Catholic as they get on the scoreboard. Three straight hits, throw in a wild pitch. And it's 8-2. Paulo getting himself a base hit for a couple of RBI. So it started out easy enough, two outs. But then Smith, Bradley Loren, and Paulo all got base hits. And the first baseman, Nick Pazia, has struck out and reached on an error. That was the error. I still feel bad about giving Bobby Alcock an error. He went behind the third base bag, fielded it. The strong throw would have had him, but it pulled Pacheco off the bag. Tried to hold up and couldn't. Pitch was up and in. He swung right through it, so it's one ball and two strikes. Excuse me, it's 0-2 to count. Couldn't hold up on that pitch. Slices it foul off to that grassy knoll behind first base. Strike three called on the outside corner. Good pitch by Cabral. Pazia didn't agree. He took it, thought it was outside. But I knocked the heck out with those three straight hits. They get on the board. We'll move into the bottom half of the fifth. It's now 8-2. St. Mary's on top. It'll be 6, 7, and 8 for the Spartans. Facing Mike Paulo, who will start an inning for the third time. He can relief in the second. Zach Frankel is going to be the new right fielder. Actually, the right fielder, Paula, was going into center field. So we'll have to wait and see where Frankel hits. They got a new left fielder as well. Luciano went into run for DeCenzo. He's now the DH, so he's hitting in DeCenzo's spot. Fouls it off his foot, and that hurts even more on a cold day like this. Hit up the middle. Smith bobbled it just enough. Base hit for Luciano. Austin Foglietta was bunted for a base hit and scored and grounded out into a double play. Hit it right on the nose and hit it just to the shortstop side of second base going into center field, and Smith made a very nice play. He was perfectly positioned for a very easy 6-3 double play. Hit to second. They get one, they won't get two. Avan Cabral walked, forcing in a run for an RBI and scored. Last time up, he was called out on strikes. On the inside corner for a strike. It's going to be a base hit in the right field, bouncing in front of the right fielder. Ethan Weiss hitting for corner. Down and away for a ball. Hit to third. They tag the runner, and they throw it away. Looking for the double play. So they get the runner going to third. They'll move up on the error. First error in the ballgame for Arlington Catholic. Pagliozzi went into play second base in place of Reddy. So it's Colby Magliozzi hitting. In for a strike quickly, 0-2. Hit foul back. High and tight for a ball. Some players coming in. Kip might be playing a game after this. This place is used. Most places have a field. They have one high school. Here in Lynn, we have five. Five high schools use this field. We got deuces wild, two balls, two strikes, two outs, 2-1. Popped up. Long run, not going to get there. Good effort by McEnany. Got to go a long way to the Arlington Catholic dugout. Hit foul back again. Slowly hit the third. They're going to have to hurry. They got him by a step. Another nice play by Simmons, the third baseman. So St. Mary's leaves a couple in scoring position in the bottom of the fifth. We've completed five in this Catholic Central League battle. St. Mary's 8, Arlington Catholic 2. Jared Capola will be the new pitcher as we start the sixth inning. Cabral will go to shortstop. Marquelo Paulo is the hitter. He's now the center fielder. He's walked and struck out. In for a strike. Low for a ball. Just got a piece and fouled it back. Hit off the bare hand of DeFilippo. He tried to get it, didn't use the glove, he used the bare hand and tipped over. It'll be a hit. for Paulo. Austin Hall is the hitter. He went in to play left field. So Capral goes five, gives up two runs that were earned, five hits, walked a couple, struck out four, and gave Derek Dana five good innings. Capolo trying to finish it off. So a hit and a walk, put two on. Anthony Pizza was the center fielder. He's now the second baseman. Pops it up. Long run. Nice job by Mulready. That's a long run almost to the dugout. And I said Mulready, he was the starting catcher. That's Foglietta. That's Will Foglietta. Making a very nice play, chasing that ball down. Sam McEnany, the catcher, has bounced to the pitcher, shingled, bounced out third to first. Moynihan making a nice play. Slicing it foul off to the right side. Those blue skies disappeared very quickly. In for a strike. Hit the third. They step on the bag for one to throw to first. They get the double play. Nice job by Terrence Moynihan. And Pacheco, I think, got stepped on at first base. Let's hope he's going to be okay. He's favoring that right ankle. Let's hope he's going to be all right. Arlington Catholic is down their last three outs. Terrence Moynihan has come in and made two very nice plays at third base. That one, the double play. Had a back up a little bit, run to the bag for the easy force, but then the long throw across the diamond. And he gets the out. So Paulo is going to go back to third base. Anthony Pizza is going to be the new pitcher. And that means Simmons goes back to second base. Tyler Lett, Will Foglietta, Jared Capola will be the three hitters for the Spartans in the bottom of the sixth. Well on their way to their fourth win to go 4-2. Arlington Catholic, unless they have a very big seventh inning, is going to drop under 500 to 3-4. Shamir's just being shady. Shamir's will be right back here tomorrow afternoon taking on Spellman. Well, that is perfect. Walked in the first. Walked with the bases loaded for an RBI and scored the second. Doubled and scored in the fourth. So he's 1-for-1 with 2 runs scored and RBI. He's been on base 3 times. So Paulo goes 3 2/3 innings. Gives up 5 hits. Didn't walk a batter, struck out 2, hit 1, gave up a run that was earned. He settled back at third base where he started the game. High for a ball. Arlington Catholic hasn't walked a batter since the second inning, but they walked 3 in the second inning and also hit 2. They gifted St. Mary's with most of those 7 runs. 3 scored on Moretti's big bases loaded double. The other scored on 3 walks and a hit batsman. Slice foul off to the right side. Just that pitch was high and tight, and he just chopped at it and punched it right to the first baseman. So they get Ouellette for the first time on the ground ball to Nick Pazio at first base. Will Foglietta will be the hitter. He went in to catch when they ran for him already for the second time. He had that nice play going almost to the dugout to catch the pop-up. In for a strike. Well, the Foglietta's made their presence felt. He made a nice play going over almost to the dugout to chase down a pop-up, a long run. And Brother Austin laid down that perfect bunt in the second inning, getting a base hit and scoring a run. And now Will's on with a walk. Jared Coppola. He was the shortstop, he's now the pitcher. Up and away for a ball. Coppola's made a couple of appearances in relief. Picked up a win and 1. The runner got a walking start, got a great jump, and had no chance. He's in with a stolen base. Got a great walking lead, just busted to second base. High and tight. As we mentioned, Coppola started as the shortstop and then moved to the mound. We're going to finish it up for Avon Cabral. It fouled back to the screen. Get way out in front. That one hit it way up in the air, pulling it foul. Off to the left side. Swing and a miss. He got him. Chased the pitch down the way. This is Kyle Ouellette hitting for Pacheco. This should be Corey Ouellette. Pacheco was 1-for-3 with it. Run scored. Solid shot into left center field. Long run, they're not going to get there. So both Ouellettes get doubles in the game. The Ouellette family is happy. We mentioned they both played together on the same defensive line, back of the blue line for St. Mary's in hockey. They did a very good job. They played well together. This is Luciano, who went in when they took DeCenzo out, pinch running for him for the second time. After he got on the second time, he got a base hit his first time up. So Corey Ouellette matches his brother's double. His double brings in a run. Off the pitcher's glove. The play goes 1-3 for the third out. But St. Mary's adds another run. They've got their 7-run cushion back. They got back the 2 runs that Arlington Catholic scored. So Arlington Catholic down their last 3 outs. We finished 6 here at Fraser Field. St. Mary's 9, Arlington Catholic 2. 2, 3, and 4. For Arlington Catholic as we start the 7th inning. So the family affair, both Ouellettes have got doubles. Kyle Ouellette scored 2. Corey Ouellette knocked in 1 with his double. Both Foglietas have made their marks. We mentioned the defensive play by Will Foglietta, the catcher. The bunt single by Austin Foglietta. Both of them have scored runs in the game. As Simmons punches the ball into right field for a base hit. Jason Smith flied to center, bounced into a fielder's choice, singled and scored the first run for Arlington Catholic in that 2-run fifth inning. Swing and a miss. He's facing Coppola for the first time. Starting his second inning of work after coming in for Cabral. Off the catcher's glove, that's going to move the runner down. Pass ball, puts the runner in scoring position. Low for a ball. Two hit straight up in the air. Behind the plate, another nice play by Fogliata. Where that wind's blowing, nothing is easy. That's his second put out. Zach Frankel is the hitter. Pitches low for a ball. He went in the outfield. Hit the shot. Cabral makes the play. Hunker Catholic down to their last out. High for a ball. In for a strike. This is Cam Gennetti hitting for Paulo. Slices it to left field. Just went foul. It was fair most of the way down and just slipped out foul. One ball, two strikes to the pinch hitter. Swing and a miss for strike three. They'll throw him out, and that'll do it. We'll leave another runner on base, Arlington Catholic. First strikeout. So Coppola gave up a couple of hits, walked a batter, got a strikeout. Cabral will get the win. St. Mary's will go to 4-2. Arlington Catholic will drop to 3-4. It was all in the second inning. St. Mary's got 7. They batted 10. 7 of them scored. 3 walks and a hit. Bassman forced in 4 of the runs. And then John Moretti with a big 3-run bases clearing double to make it 7-0. They made it 8 in the fourth inning. Ouellette led with a double. Moretti got hit by a pitch. And then Jared Coppola got the RBI hit, knocking in the run to make it 8. Arlington Catholic got 2 in the fifth. They got 3 straight hits. A wild pitch moved the runners up. And Mike Paulo got the base hit, knocking in the 2 runs. And that made it 8-2. St. Mary's added one in the sixth. Will Fogliata led with a walk, stole second, and scored on the base hit by Corey Ouellette to make it 9-2. And that's the way it ended up, 9-2, as St. Mary's will go to 4-2. So Colin Reddy got hit by a pitch, getting him an RBI, scored a run. Kyle Ouellette had 2 walks, a double, scored 2, got an RBI. John Moretti was on base twice, got hit by a pitch, got that big 3 RBI double. Coppola had a base hit, knocking in a run. Pacheco had a base hit and scored a run. We hope he's going to be all right with that ankle. Corey Ouellette hit for him, got an RBI double. DJ Jacenzo got hit by a pitch, got a base hit, scored a run. Luciano in his place got a base hit. Austin Fogliata got that beautiful bunt down the third base line, was on base twice, scored a run. Cabral had a walk and a single in 3 trips. The walk got him an RBI, he scored a run. Connor Donahue drew another walk with the bases loaded for an RBI, and he scored a run. So it was everybody getting involved, especially in that second inning, as they put 7 on the board, and they win it going away 9-2. They'll be right back here tomorrow looking to go 5-2 on the season. But right now they'll settle for 4-2. Arlington Catholic will drop to 3-4. St. Mary's 9, Arlington Catholic 2. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm John Hoffman saying we'll see you next time.